Good morning, children. Let us start our day with today's thought. Think big, trust yourself, and make it happen. Think big means you should have big goals, big aims in your life. Trust yourself. Trust yourself means you should have faith in yourself that you are able to achieve all those goals. And make it happen means you should work hard to achieve those goals and achieve those goals. So think big, trust yourself and make it happen means have a big goals, big aims in your life. Work hard to achieve those goals. Okay, children. Now today we are going to start a new topic, that is 4.4, story time. What do you see? Now this is a story from Mahabharat, and this story is about Pandavas and Kauravas. Pandavas were five brothers, and the eldest among them was Yudhishthir. After Yudhishthir there was Bhim. Third number is Arjun, and after that there were twins, means two brothers, they were Nakul and Sahadev. And their guru was Dronacharya. So this is the story of Pandavas and their guru. So let us see the story. Okay. So today we are going to see 4.4 story time. What do you see? Okay. Now here paragraph is given. Let's read the paragraph first. Okay. This is a story from Mahabharata. Arjun, the prince, his brothers and cousins were being trained in archery and warcraft by the great teacher Dronacharya. So as I have told you, this is the story from Mahabharata, and their guru was Dronacharya. So as I told you before, that this is the story of Pandavas and Kaurava. So Arjun and his brother and his cousins were taking training in archery. We have seen they were trained in archery. Now what do you mean by archery? Archery means the art of shooting with bow and arrow. So can you see? So all the Pandavas and Kauravas, they were taking training. So Arjun and his brothers and his cousins, they were taking training in archery. Archery means the art of shooting with bow and arrow. And warcraft. Warcraft means the knowledge and skills in conducting military operations. So they were taking training from their guru Dronacharya. So he is the guru, and all the Pandavas and Kauravas, they were, and his cousins, they were taking training from Dronacharya. Now let's see the next paragraph. Once Dronacharya called all his students. He said, "I would like to see how you are practicing your archery skills. I will take a test." So what happened? One day, Dronacharya called all his students and said, "Today I am going to take your test." As in the school, your teacher takes your test, na? So Dronacharya also wanted to take their test to know how they are practicing their archery skills. So Dronacharya wanted to know whether they are practicing properly or not. So he wanted to take their test. So Dronacharya called all the students together. He placed a wooden parrot on the branch of tree. So to take the test, what happened? Dronacharya asked all his students to get ready with their bow and arrow. He called all his students to get ready. So he called all his students together, and he placed means hang, a wooden parrot on the branch of tree. Can you see? So a parrot is placed here on the branch of the tree. So can you see, Dronacharya called all the students together and he has placed a wooden parrot on the branch of tree. Now what happened? He said, now all of you get ready with your bow and arrow for the test. Look at the wooden bird on the branch of the tree. You have to hit exactly its eye. So what happened? Why Dronacharya has called all the students? So he asked all his students to get ready with their bow and arrow. Bow means dhanushya and arrow means baan. So he asked all his students to get ready with bow and arrow. Can you see this? So this is the bow, this one, and this is the long stick, that this is the arrow. So he asked all his students to get ready with their bow and arrow for the test. He asked them to look at the wooden bird on the branch of the tree. So Dronacharya told them to look at the wooden bird on the branch of the tree, and they have to exactly hit the eye of the bird. So they have to hit here in the middle of the eye of the wooden bird. Okay, now let's see what happened next. All the students were excited. They stood in a line for the test. First came Bhim. He stretched his bow and set his arrow. As he was about to shoot his wooden bird's eye, Dronacharya said, wait, Bhim, tell me, what do you see? So when all the students came, they heard this. So all the students were very excited. Excited means, what do you mean by excited? Excited means happy, eager. They were all eager for the test. So all of them stood in a line for the test. So all of them, they were ready with their bow and arrow and they stood in a line for the test. Now first came Bhim. Now the first turn was of Bhim. So he stretched. Stretched means, what do you mean by stretch? Stretch means spread. Khichna. So he spread stretched his bow and set his arrow to shoot the eye of the bird. So in the last picture you have seen, see. So he was ready. He was stretching his bow and he was setting his arrow. So he stretched the bow and set the arrow to shoot the eye of the bird. So when he was just about to shoot the wooden bird, so he was targeting the bird, the eye of the bird, at that time what happened? Dronacharya stopped him and asked him, first tell me, what do you see? And Dronacharya stopped him and asked him, wait, just tell me, what do you see? Now we will see what Bhim has replied. So Bhim replied, Guruji, I see the sky, the clouds and the sun. Dronacharya said, Bhim, you will not shoot the wooden bird right now. So when Dronacharya asked him, what do you see? So what Bhim replied? Bhim replied, he said, Guruji, I can see the clouds, the sun and the sky. So he can see the clouds and the sun and the sky. After hearing this, Dronacharya said, what he said? Bhim, you will not shoot the wooden bird right now. No, at this time you will not shoot. Now we will see what happened next. So then came Yudhishthir. Dronacharya asked him the same question. Tell me, what do you see? So after Bhim comes the Yudhishthir. And Dronacharya asked him the same question. When he was shooting the bird, he stopped him and he asked him the same question. Tell me, what do you see? What Do you see around the birds? Bird. So Yudhishthir replied. What did he replied? Guruji, I see the wooden bird, the branches and the tree too. So what Yudhishthir replied? He said that I can see the bird, wooden bird and the branches and the tree on which the bird is hanging. So what happened then? No, said Dronacharya, you are not ready to shoot yet. So when Yudhishthir told him that he can see the bird and the branches on which it is hanging and the tree, so Dronacharya said, no, you are not ready to shoot yet. So he came back. All the students were asked the same questions and they all told about many things they see around. They told that they could see the sky, the clouds, the sun, the tree, the branches, the wooden bird and their friends too. But Dronacharya was not happy with their answer. So one by one all of them they were coming and Dronacharya was asking the same question to all of them. That what do you see? And they were telling the answer. Some of them they were saying that they can see the clouds. Then some of them they were saying they can see the sun. Then clouds, trees, branches, wooden birds. Some of them were saying that they can see their friends too. But Dronacharya was not at all happy with their answer. He did not. This was not his expected answer. So what happened next? We will see. He stopped everyone. Nobody got a chance to shoot the wooden bird. So whenever they were answering like this, so Dronacharya stopped them from shooting the bird. And nobody get the chance to shoot the wooden bird. And so no one get the chance to. All were eager, all were excited to shoot, to give the test. But no one get the chance to hit the bird or shoot the bird, wooden bird. Finally, it was Arjun's turn. Arjun was very good at archery. So can you see? Now, finally, Arjun got the chance to shoot the bird. And Arjun was very good at archery. Archery, I have already told you, archery means the art of shooting with bow and arrow. So he was very good at archery. So when he came forward means when he came in front, Dronacharya asked him the same question. So again, Arjun was also asked the same question. What do you see, Arjun? So Dronacharya asked the same question to Arjun also. Arjun looked at the wooden bird and focusing on his eye, he replied, Guruji, I can see only the eye of the wooden bird. So when Dronacharya asked him the same question, Arjun looked at the wooden bird. So he looked at the wooden bird and focusing means concentrating on a particular thing. So he focused on the wooden bird, focusing on its eye. He was just focusing on its eye and he answered that, Guruji, I can see only the eye of the wooden bird. What else do you see? Asked Dronacharya. Now Dronacharya again asked him, what else you see around it? Or kya dikh raha hai tumko? Nothing else but the eye of the wooden bird. That is all I can see, replied Arjun. So now Arjun replied, no Guruji, I cannot see anything else than the eye of the wooden bird. I can see only the eye of the bird. Now, Dronacharya, let's see what happened. Shoot, said Dronacharya happily, and Arjun shoot the arrow. It hit the wooden bird's eye exactly. The wooden bird fell down. So Dronacharya was happy. He was very pleased to hear the answer of Arjun that he can see only the eye of the wooden bird. So Dronacharya was very happy to listen that and he ordered Arjun to shoot the bird and Arjun shoot the arrow. As soon as he shoot the arrow, it hit the wooden bird's eye exactly and the arrow hit the target. That is the eye of the wooden bird and the wooden bird fell down. Can you see? It hit the eye exactly and the bird fell down. Dronacharya patted on Arjun's back and said, focusing on your goals help you to achieve it. So now Dronacharya was very happy to hear the answer, and then Arjun was able to hit exactly the eye of the bird. So Dronacharya patted on Arjun's back. Patted means when you do something, our elders pat us. Pat means shabashi dete hai na. They pat on our back. हमारी पीठ पे शाबाशी देते हैं. So Dronacharya patted on Arjun's back and said, what he said, focusing on your goals help you to achieve it. Focusing means, already I have told you, concentrating on your goal. If you concentrate on your goal, if you concentrate on your aim, that will help you to achieve it. So if you want to achieve the good marks, if you want to score good marks, or if you want to achieve the good personality, if you focus on these things, you, that will help you to achieve this, and that is very easy for you to achieve the goals what you want. So children, I hope you have liked the story. Yes, and you should follow the guidelines of Dronacharya, that focusing on your goal help you to achieve it. So I hope you have understood the story and you like the story. Yes, now it's your homework time. What is your homework? You have to read the chapter thoroughly. Okay, after this, in our online class, we will take the reading practice of this chapter. So till then, we will meet you in the next period. Till then, thank you and happy learning.